Welcome back. Good morning. Well, we had a request today to talk more about our personal experiences. What has gone on in our lives since our last visit to China?
前几次来中国以后，我们的生活中有什么变化？
And to give you a glimpse into how we are in the flow of the spirit.
然后我们可以就是给你们大家就是一个机会去了解一下我们是如何在圣灵的这个流动中就是过着我们的生活。
So everything in form is just like a pointer, it just points towards the experience.
所以实际上在表象层面来看，任何发生的事情只不过是指向那个我们的内心的内在的这样的一个经历。
And so I will summarize my work with the Course in Miracles.
所以我可以给大家总结一下我对奇迹课程这个法门的修炼的经历。
I came across the Course book in 1986. And so the first 5 years was a very intimate practice with the Course.
所以一开始的五年就是完全是非常私人的就是去自己修行。
I really didn't know too many people at this time who are working with the Course in Miracles.
当时我也不认识任何修行奇迹课程的其他学员。
The first few years, I really didn't know anybody else. I was just working with the book on my own. And then I began to meet other students who were very devoted to the study. And we had the beginnings of forming a little community. And in those days, there was some travel, but mostly nearby to where I lived. And we used a household in Michigan to form our first little Course in Miracles community. And these people called themselves my students. And I think there was only about seven of us at the beginning. But in 1991, I began feeling called to travel. So that was 25 years ago. And I began traveling extensively around the United States. And in one sense, I consider that also the beginning of the world travel. Because I did leave the United States and go up to an island off the coast of Canada. But most of the travels for the first 8 years were in the United States. And then around 2003, I began going to South America and then to other countries. When Francis and I came to China in 2012, I think we had about seven people total.
Francis和我第一就是在2012年的时候。
how we felt. We felt like a celebration.
Yeah.
It felt like a tour around China with so much happiness.
当时2012年的时候我们一共8个人一起过来的从美国然后当时在中国做了一个就是大规模的这样的一个旅程
I've heard that we are having a wedding here today.
我听说今天我们这边会有一个婚礼在这个场所
So we have all kinds of nice sounds and music surrounding us today.
所以今天我们早上已经有音乐有各种各样的声音的音乐庆祝
But even back in 2012, we were beginning to talk about the symbol of community. And a little after that, we did a session in Shanghai with a little bit of a discussion around having a community in China.
然后当时我们在上海的时候也跟一群学员交流就是谈到在中国设立一个奇迹社区的这样一个想法
So I would like to address that topic this morning in the context of our lives
所以今天早上我就可以在就是跟我们的切身经历相关的这样谈一下这个奇迹社区的这样一个概念
Most of you know that A Course in Miracles is a self-study book
我们大家都知道奇迹课程是一本自修课程
That is designed to put you in contact with your internal teacher
它的目的就是想让你在修行的过程中逐渐跟自己内心的这个圣灵相连接
So the book itself is not designed to be used specifically for communities or groups
所以这个本书本身并不是就是设计出是给一群的人共修或者是给一个社区共修的
In fact, I think it is a very complete system that you could just work with the Holy Spirit and Jesus and the Course and open up your heart and mind completely
但它本身实际上是一个非常完善的一个系统所以你完全可以就是自己修这本书然后最终跟你内心的指引相连接然后完全开悟
But it's been very interesting in my life as I've just followed the guidance.
但是对我来讲，我的这个经历就是我一直在跟随内心的这个指引。
I remember reading a sentence from Jesus in A Course in Miracles.
我还记得我当时在这本书里面读到耶稣的一句话。
And he said, "This course will be believed entirely or not at all."
他当时在奇迹课程里面说你要么就是完全的相信这本书里所讲的东西要么就是完全不信
And so it gave me a sense of how deep and uncompromising the teachings are
所以当时就给我一种感觉就这本书是多么的深而且多么的毫不妥协
Ultimately, it's not about levels or approaching God. It's about having the experience of God. When Helen Schuckman, the scribe of the course, was asked about how many books to publish,
导录者这个海伦舒曼当时一开始把这本书写下来的时候，他被问到我们要出版多少本书。
Her answer was very surprising.
他当时给的答案非常的令人惊讶。
She said four.
他说我们出版4本书。
Four books.
这是4册。
And her friend Judy said, "Do you mean?"
40,000?
Helen said no.
他说不,
she said, "Do you mean 4,000?
那你说的是4,000册?
Helen said no.
然后海伦说不是,
four.
我说的是4册。
One for me.
一本书给我,
one for Bill.
一本书给别人,
one for Ken.
一本书给那个Ken。
And one for Judy. Who was asking the question?
Yeah.
And actually, Helen did not even feel that the course was to be translated to other languages. But she was the scribe. It was not her function to deal with other things that would come in the plan. But she did ask Jesus, how many people on earth is this book for? Let's say in the first generation, in a typical human lifetime. And Jesus told her, you could count those people on two hands. That means in the entire first generation of all the people in the world that work with the course. You could count on two hands. That will experience the teachings of the course fully. And so this again points to the depth of self-realization or spiritual enlightenment. He was referring, I think, to his teaching that this course will be believed entirely or not at all. Because the Course in Miracles is about accepting atonement. Two places in the book, he says that is the sole responsibility. The only responsibility. Is to accept the atonement for yourself. And he's not talking about your personality self. Because that's part of the block to the atonement. He's talking about the mind. Accepting the correction for the error in the mind. So, in my life, this has taken the form of many encounters. And meeting many people around the world in over 40 countries. But it has also taken the form of a very devoted community. Very much like in this country, you have very devoted Buddhist communities.
就像在中国, 我们有非常虔诚的佛教徒, 还有, 佛教徒的那个寺庙,
where Buddhist monks come and devote their entire life to the teachings of the Buddha.
然后佛教徒的僧人他们会抛开自己的一生, 然后把自己一生都投入到这个对这个佛教的
Yes, to one purpose of recognizing the Buddha nature. As the self. And so in our lives, we work very closely with a small group of people. I think at last count there was about a total of 41 people.
And
And these people are sprinkled around the world. They are not living in one location or one space. We have some over in a center in near Barcelona, Spain. And some that are very near Guadalajara, Mexico. Some are in the United States, in Utah. And then there are some down in Australia, outside of Sydney, Australia. And when we came to China, we mentioned that we follow two guidelines in our communities. So nobody is asked to take vows, like monks take vows. We don't have any vows. And the two guidelines are, one, no private thoughts. And two, no people pleasing. In other words, no acting for external approval. And these two guidelines are designed to help you get in touch with your emotions and thoughts. These guidelines are designed to undo denial and repression. And bring everything that was pushed out of awareness back into awareness. And so even our first visit to Beijing in
2011,
we broke the large group of 100 people into four expression sessions. And people had huge emotions coming up. I have done expression sessions all over the world, but in China, it was like a volcano erupting. Susie's laughing, she remembers. And this was by design. We wanted the emotions to come up. Because you cannot heal from these emotions unless you let them up into your awareness. And so we have used expression sessions for a number of years. And in our communities, we still have expression sessions. There was a small group of people that practiced here in China. And we met with that group in Shanghai. And they said it was very difficult. They said there was a lot of intensity of emotions between the group. And And some even said, I guess I was tempted to kill somebody else. I got so angry. Yeah. And this is why oftentimes the emotions are pushed into the unconscious mind. The emotions are so intense that you seem to be dysfunctional. You don't seem to be able to function as a human being. But if you practice this on a daily basis, it really helps you open up in a very fast way. So those who have been in our community for many years, they hold the presence of non-judgment and stillness.
他们能够为新的学员提供这样的一个临在, 就是说他们是不会去评价任何人。
And let the others in the group bring up all their intense emotions.
然后他们就可以允许其他的新的学员来了以后, 把内心里面积累的情绪带到表面上来。
And in these groups, there is no correcting each other.
然后在我们的那个练习的过程中, 我们也不允许大家互相的指责或者是教导对方。
There is an allowance for people to start and finish their expressions without being interrupted.
我们鼓励那些释放情绪的人从一开始到结束，他们有足够的时间和空间，而不被任何人打扰。
So there is no crosstalk or trying to talk over other people.
所以我们不希望有人会中途打断他们，或者是去说一些没有相关，或者相关或者不相关的话。
It is a very sacred, prayerful experience of allowing those emotions to come up. And not judging the emotions. And not attaching a story to the emotions. Just letting them arise. Without attempting to fix anything.
也不会去试图改变什么或者是纠正什么。
And so this practice has been very, very helpful for our communities.
所以这个练习就或者是这个功课对我们的奇迹社区的学员帮助都是非常大。
And it seems to freeze up the mind's energy to be used in collaborative projects.
然后当大家长时间的有这个练习以后，他们的心灵里面就会有更多的能量去用来去做真正的有用的事情，比如说跟大家一起合作做一些圣灵引导的这些功课。
So everyone in the community is open to be used by the Spirit for a larger plan.
所以我们社区里面的每一个人都是愿意把自己的内心敞开，然后听从圣灵的指引，去做圣灵想让我们在这个时间完成的事情。
Even when we arrived here at the airport, we were asked questions about our community, whether anybody is working full-time or part-time.
那么就是我们刚刚到北京的时候，也有朋友问我们，就是说能不能了解一下你们的奇迹社区有没有人是一边工作一边在社区里面修行的这样的问题。
But everyone in the community is very focused on projects, and no one is working in exchange for money or anything reciprocity.
对我们的社区里面的成员，现在是非常专注于把身心和精力全都投入到圣灵指引的这些项目上去，所以他们并没有人是说，就是说是为了挣钱而去做任何的事情。So
this has been very important for us as well, because the mind can be very focused when it's not concerned about making a living.
所以这个对我们来讲也非常重要，因为当我们的 精力不去放在就如何去生存，这个问题上的时候，实际上我们的心灵中精力上有很大一部分就被释放出来，可以被圣灵更好的运用。
And we really teach that the intuition or the spirit within is the instructor, is the boss.
我们就是鼓励大家去认识到我们的直觉或者说我们内心的圣灵是我们的老板。
We take it very literally when it says in the Course that Jesus is in charge of the plan of atonement.
当奇迹课程里面说基督耶稣是指挥这个觉醒计划的唯一的这个幕后的指使人的时候，我们是对这句话非常认真的对待的。
So we see that Jesus has completed his part, and now he is directing us in what we can do to be helpful for everyone.
因为我们知道基督已经完成了他的那部分使命，所以他现在在指挥着我们每一个人去完成我们在这个计划中的使命。
So we're not talking about Jesus the man or Jesus the historical figure.
我们现在也不是在谈论基督这个历史人物。
It's just the presence of love that is in our hearts.
是我们内心心灵中爱的临在。
The same presence that gave us the Course in Miracles.
是这个临在把这本书引导出来的。
Is arranging and directing everything that we think and say and do.
然后这个临在实际上是在引导我们如何思考，如何说话，如何做事。
And so our community is very prayerful. We pray every day.
所以在我们的社区里面啊，祈祷是我们非常重要的一个每天的工作，就是我们经常在一起，就是聚在一起祈祷。
To be guided and directed in our daily lives.
然后想要聆听这个引导，就是我们每天应该怎么展开我们的一天。
And we seek to make all our decisions through prayer.
然后我们所有的各种决定实际上都是通过祈祷来完成的。
Recently, we had lunch with the publisher of A Course in Miracles.
最近的时候我们是去见了这个奇迹课程的出版的这个人朱迪。
And she was telling us that she had visitors that came one time and asked her what is her business plan.
她就跟我们讲过她在正常时间出版奇迹课程这个过程中有很多人问他的当时的商业计划是什么。
And she said, well, for over 40 years, they have no business plan.
他说在过去的40年中他们一点计划都没有。
They simply pray and they receive answers from the Spirit and follow.
他们从来都是祈祷然后收到圣灵给他们的指引然后去执行这个指引。
And so we laughed because we said, well, that's exactly what we do, too.
然后我们就相视一笑，因为这个也是我们执行的这个过程也是这样。
Yeah. And so, this for us is a very devotional life.
所以对我们来讲，这个是一个非常奉献的一生。
Because we find that the ego emotions are so intense.
因为我们知道小我的情绪是多么的激烈。
That we need lots of support.In going through the healing process.
然后我们也知道，就是说，当我们去真的经过这个疗，走过这个疗愈的道路的这个过程中，是需要多么需要支持。
So all of us in the community are like mighty companions to each other.
所以我们所有的人在奇迹社区里，所有人对彼此来讲，就是这个强大的道友和精神的支持。
And sometimes people who come are amazed at how much praying that we do.
然后有的时候新的那个来访者，他们会看到我们每天都是用多长的时间去祈祷，他们都很惊讶。
A few days before I was to fly to China.
在我就是来中国的前几天里。
Someone told me that they would take me to the airport.
然后就有一个人跟我说，他会那天把我开车送到机场。
But I watched in those 3 days all the shifts that were happening in the community.
但是在那个我去机场的前三天里面，在我们的社区里面发生了那么多的变化。
And on the second day, a different plan came.
然后在第二天里面，已经这计划已经改变了。
And then the night before I was coming. more people were coming, and there was another plan that was given.
然后在我临走的那天晚上，因为有其他的更多的人来我们的社区，所以又有新的计划又出来了。到底谁送我去机场？
And it just showed how we live so much in the moment.
所以这就是一个例子，就是说我们是完全活在当下的。
That it has to truly be given to what serves the whole.
我们的决定一定是要。就说是基于到底什么才能是造福全体的
Because there were, I think, three of us that were leaving on the same day.
因为那天我们实际上有三个不同的人都要去机场坐飞机。
And two were flying east, and I was flying west to China.
然后有两个人是往美国东部飞，然后我是往西部飞到中国。
And so it ended up being two trips to the airport.
所以最终是要去机场两趟。
But if you would sit with us in our community, you would see that there is this high level of communication.
如果你跟我们在一起的话，就是看着我们怎么做决定的话，你会发现我们就是互相交流，我们就是总是不停地处在这个交流状态当中。
And a very high level of transparency about feelings.
而且不管是什么情况，我们都对自己的感受非常非常的透明。
Because it's like a tuning, a way of tuning in with the spirit. What would you have me do in this moment?
因为是在这种情况下，我们才能找到这个非常微妙的这个差别，然后能够找到圣灵对我们的指引。
And so.This has evolved since our last trip to China.
然后让就是说，在我们一开始来中国的这个行程之后的这几年，我们这个也有往前发展。
I would say that through prayer, our rituals have fallen away.
所以就是说，在我们祈祷的这个过程中，实际上很多的。形式上的这些构架也慢慢的就是开始不存在了。
So we are unlike very structured communities.
所以我们的社区实际上也不是在形式上有很多的结构。
Where the day is planned in advance.
然后每一天都是很有计划的，计划好的。
Usually we wake up in the morning and we don't have much of an idea of what's going to happen.
通常我们早上醒来的时候，就是对这一天到底。会发生什么事情？什么时间会怎么样？都是不太清楚的。
So our days are very spontaneous.
所以我们是非常自发性的，允许这一天自己的展开。
And if you had a camera watching Francis,
如果你有一个摄像机能跟着 Francis 的话
，You'd see that she has many Skype calls with people all over the world, sometimes all day.
你会看到他每天都是在Skype 上做交流，跟全世界不同的人。有的时候从早到晚，一天整个的时间都是用来做这个。
So it's like prayer and communication combined.
所以对我们来讲，就是祈祷再加上交流是结合的。
Because there is a very high level of trust.
我们而且有就是互相的信任程度非常的高。
And everyone has a desire to only make decisions with the Holy Spirit.
然后每一个人在心里面都有这个唯一的愿心，就是要跟着圣灵的选择去做决定。
And sometimes the phone calls involve emotions.
然后有的时候我们比如说做这种电话是做电话咨询是。对这些情绪上的释发呀，或者是跟情绪上有做一些心理咨询。
Even after years of practice with the course, there can be emotional breakdowns.
哪怕你是在练习奇迹很多年，你还是有可能会有一些精神上崩溃的时候。
Where people in the community find themselves under a great deal of strain or stress.
有的时候我们社区里面的成员。也会有在突然会发现自己精神上变得非常的紧张或者是崩溃的状态。
And it's not coming from things that seem to be worldly stresses.
然后这些也并不是源自于外来的因素，并不是说是这个事件有什么事情造成的。
Because none of the people have a boss telling them that they need to do this or they'll be fired. They all have places to stay and live in very nice centers around the world. None of them have to make stressful career decisions or career choices. But these emotional resistances that are of the ego will come into awareness. And this is a course that uses relationships, and there's a lot of mirroring that goes on in the community. So these can be just reflections that are perceived in other people.
所以当我们每次看到有这个情绪的时候，实际上很多人就是看到从对方反映出来自己心理上的问题。
Or maybe it's taking on a new project and there's a fear or a doubt about how to accomplish the project. Oftentimes, the resistance has to do with the flow of support.
然后很多时候这个反抗性实际上是来源于对于怎么支持，就是说到底应该怎么支持其他人。
So basically, all of us feel like we are here to support Jesus and the plan.
因为我们都是感觉到我们在做的每一件事情都是来支持圣灵，支持他在这个市场的这个计划。
And when everyone remembers that, things flow very beautifully and easily.
然后当我们每个人都能够认清这一点的时候，所有的事情就会流动得非常畅通。
But when ego thoughts and concerns come in, then the flow goes of worry and concern about the body.
但是每当小我开始主宰我们的思想的时候，我们就会把重心放在身体上的这些念头上。
Or worry about the personality self.
或者担心我们自我人格的这些问题。
Some grievance from the past coming up into awareness.
然后一些对过去的一些内疚啊，或者是情绪也会出现。
Or some concerns about the future.
或者是对未来的一些担心会出现。
Or some expectation that the world should look differently than it looks.
或者是对这个世界的一些要求，认为它 不应该是这样子的。
But we come back into prayer.
但是每当这个情况出现的时候，我们就需要一起再回来祈祷。
We use prayer for every answer.
我们祈祷是我们找到答案的唯一的方式。
We do not have a democracy and vote on things.
在我们的社区里面，我们也不进行民主的投票。
We have no dictator telling us how things have to be. We keep praying and praying and asking and asking. And the answers are given to us. And they're always very practical. We always have a feeling of peace and calm when we listen and follow what we are given. Recently, we had a family that visited our community. And it was a family of one of our community residents.
这是我们社区成员的父母来到我们社区里面访问。
And the family went through much healing while they were visiting.
然后当他们在我们社区里面住了这几天，他们每一个人家庭成员都受到了很大的疗愈。
And before they left, they made the comment that this community is 500 years ahead of its time.
然后当时他们在这些家庭成员离开之前，他们就说你们的社区比这个社会要先进500年。
And so we were happy about that. It was like a compliment to our style of praying and listening.
然后我们很欣慰，就是我们的这种生活方式，就是大家一起祈祷，然后接受疗愈的这种生活方式，能够得到其他人的慰藉。
Because most families and corporations don't have that level of prayer or communication.
因为在大部分普通家庭里面，或者是公司里面，这个都不是他们做决定的方式。
The goal of a corporation is not spiritual enlightenment. It's profit, making a profit.
像在大多数的机构或者是公司里面，他们的目的也不是开悟，也不是觉醒，他们是要谋求利润。
And oftentimes, even the goal of the family is survival of the family.
然后对于正常的家庭来讲，通常来讲，他们的目的也只不过是家庭成员生存下去。
So that the biological family can prosper and then pass on the prosperity to the children.
或者是整个家族能够兴旺，然后能够一代传一代。
But peace of mind is not the goal.
但是对通常来讲，心灵的平安都不是他们的目标。
However, we have discovered with the Course in Miracles that peace of mind has to be the goal.
但是通过奇迹课程，我们了解到，心灵平安必须是我们唯一的目的。
It really has to be our only goal.
必须是我们唯一的目的。
We cannot be concerned with productivity.
我们不能关注其他的任何的事情。
Or trying to change the world.
或者是试图去改变这个世界。
Or changing society.
或者改变这个社会。
Or changing the government.
改变政府。
Or even changing the weather.
或者是改变这个天气状况。
We really have to be responsible for our peace of mind.
我们唯一的职责就是我们要找到内心灵的平安。
And we have found that this shared purpose is very important.
我们发现，如果我们的目标是一致的话，这种共有的目标是非常重要的。
And those that feel this is so important, they usually stay in the community.
然后真正把这个目标当成是最重要的事情的人，往往会留在我们的社区里面。
And sometimes people will say, "Oh, I don't know if that's all I want out of this world."
但是有的时候，有些人会说我不确定这个是我唯一的目标，在这活着一世的唯一的目标。
They'll say, "I think I still have some things I want to try and taste in this world."
他们会说，在这个世界上，我还有其他的东西我还没有尝试过，我还想要尝试。
And they will leave and go tasting.
通常这样的情况下，他们会离开我们的社区，去追寻他们想要追寻的东西。
Yes, if the mind wants to pursue another goal, then sometimes it has to be given the chance to do that.
如果你的心灵真的想追求一些什么东西的话，你还是需要被给予这个机会和这个空间去做的。
And some of these same people will come back and say, "Oh, that wasn't worth it."
但是很多时候，过了一段时间以后，同样这些人会回来说，哎，好像也不太值得我的时间花在这上面。
And I value peace of mind more than my other goal.
现在我可以说我觉得心灵平安对我来讲更有价值。
Yeah. So that's pretty much how our lives, how Francis and I have been living our lives since we were last in China.
所以这个就是大概的一个概况，就是自从上次我们离开中国以后，我们的生活中有些什么情况。
Just in this year alone, I think I have visited all of the communities.
哪怕就是在今年的一年时间里面，我实际上是在我们全世界所有的中心都待过的。
And I feel a little bit like Mother Teresa going around to all the communities.
我觉得我有点像是特蕾莎修女在晚期的时候的那个状态，就是她会在全世界，在他们各个中心里面停留一段时间。
Or like Dalai Lama going around and visiting the monks around the world. We share a lot of joy and happiness and laughter. And also, Francis and I are able to go out and do retreats like this. This trip, we have 3 days here in China and 2 days in Japan. And then a couple weeks down in Australia. We've also done a week retreat in Finland. And a 5 day retreat in Holland. And so we have space to still do some retreats that involve going around to many places. But most of our daily focus is with our community. This morning when I knocked on Francis's door, she was on a Skype call with a friend in Mexico. I think most of the time when I knock on Francis's door, she's on a Skype call. Talking to somebody somewhere in the world. And then I used to come in and sit down and she tells me how the family is doing. So really, we live with 41 people. And we know what's their state of mind, what they're going through, pretty closely, intimately. And they know that they can always reach out and talk to us. And it again comes down to prayer. They call when they feel they really need to talk or they're very strongly guided to talk. So that's an update. We were asked, requested, what's going on in your lives, day by day. So that's the deal. Okay, well, we are again open to using the microphone to field the questions. There's a question back there.
The right.
David,
I spent the whole day yesterday thinking whether I have any questions to ask, but didn't find any. And I decided to surrender.
回到家里，直到今天早晨，我突然有了灵感。
Then after the day yesterday and this morning, I suddenly had some inspiration.
这个话题也是之前我弟弟一直跟我探讨过，但是没有最终找到答案的一个问题。
This topic is something I've been discussing with my brother for a long time, but we never really find a solution.
我弟弟他个人对。
My brother has a very strong interest in the I Ching in China. And we we share this common interest to explore spirituality.
他也跟着我一起走过很多中国传统的法门，包括西方的新时代。
He has explored with me many, many pathways, traditional pathways in China and also the New Age movement in the West.
之后我们一直纠结的问题就是，他坚定地认为，就是首先他是知道小我剧本的，就是我们的一切的发生都在剧本当中。
So he also believes that the script is written.
我遇到行星课程之后，知道了有圣母目光。
知道。
圣母的目光。
And after of course miracles, I started to be open to the perspective of the Holy Spirit.
所以在看小我剧本的时候，我觉得任何剧本。就是我们生命当中任何事情发生都有两种目光，小我和圣灵。
So when I review the script, now I know that there are two ways of looking at the script, from the ego's perspective or from the Holy Spirit's perspective.
但是我们一直在纠结着一个问题，就是，我弟弟的意思是说，我今生是否灵修，是否遇到哪个法门？包括我修成什么样，依然在剧本当中。包括我每次跟他说什么，这些都是安排好的。
One thing.
Okay, but what we're confused about is my brother firmly believes that everything, even including the spiritual pathway, anything that I encounter, the teachers that I will meet, the things I will say, and the stage I will reach are all part of the script.
之后我是不太认可，因为我觉得既然我已经知道了有圣母目光，所以说任何一个版本的发生，我都可以跳出剧本来看。
I don't really agree with his perspective because I believe there is a Holy Spirit's way of reviewing the script, so it doesn't really matter what happens, I can still leap beyond the script and look at it from Holy Spirit's perspective.
但是我弟弟的意思，连我这种想法也依然在剧本之中。
But he's saying that even my belief,this belief is still part of the script.
比如说我遇到奇迹课程，我觉得它解答了我从小以来所有的问题和疑惑。
For example, ever since I come across A Course in Miracles, I thinkIt provides an answer for all the questions that I had.
我把奇迹课程推荐给他，但是他的感觉跟我并不一样。
And I recommend him to read A Course in Miracles, but he has very different feelings about the course.
通过昨天一天课程的感受。
And after yesterday's class,
确实让我看到很多修行多年的奇迹兄弟。并没有真正的活出奇迹。
I realize that a lot of the long-term course students actually haven't really experienced the course.
所以昨天课程结束之后，我的问题就出现了。
That's why after the class yesterday, I started to have a clarity about that question.
让我想到了我弟弟的说法，就是哪怕在场的各位兄弟，修奇迹的兄弟。修奇迹的兄弟，就是在我们知道的圣灵目光，但是他也不一定能够活出那种状态。然后这也是在剧本当中，也就是说，你什么时候开悟，或者是说你遇到什么法门，或者你能修行到什么程度，这所有的一切都在一体的计划安排之中。
It seems like what my brother thinks is right because even.When you know about the Holy Spirit's perspective, you may still choose to not live from that. So it seems like, when you're going to wake up from this dream, is all part of the script.
就我个人而言，我通过跟修行多年的这个奇迹兄弟，我自身的感受是，我在想，因为我现在刚接触几个月，那如果我在若干年之后还是这种状态，我是否能够接受？我接受不了。
I'm actually quite new to the course. I've studied for about just a few months, but I'm thinking hypothetically, if after many many years I'm at the same level, the same level as many of the long-term students, I cannot accept that.
但是我内在的另外一个声音突然提醒我，我再次被小我绑架了。就是我觉得这也是对自己最大的不接受、不臣服与接纳。
But at the same time, there's another voice telling me that I'm trapped by the ego again, and that is probably why I still have a lot of self-doubt and self-judgment.
所以我继续选择了宽恕与交托。我在想，我会在奇迹这条路上一直走下去。但是至于明天会发生什么，十年之后发生什么？
So it seems like I have no choice but to keep surrendering and keep forgiving. I know that Course in Miracles is my pathway, but I don't really know what's going to happen tomorrow or 10 years later.
就是这样，就是我自己的这个感受，还有我弟的那个问题，这两个结合到一起，然后我觉得它是相关联的。
So I think this is just where I'm at, and also I want to share my brother's perspective. I think they're related.
Thank you.
Yes, I noticed this when I came to China.
我知道我来中国。
A lot of the questions, like the one you are raising, are very sophisticated and extremely deep.
我发现我们就是中国学员问的这些问题，就像你刚才问的问题，是非常涉及到精髓部分，而且非常深奥的一个问题。
And even though you've just started the course, you are aware after one day that your brother's position in the course are aligned together.
哪怕就是在你，哪怕你是对奇迹课程其实是很新的接触的到的，然后在昨天一天的课程之后，你也能看到，就是你弟弟的那个观点和奇迹课程观点实际上有关联的。
Because this gets to the core of the idea of choice and decision.
因为这个其实上涉及到了一个根本点，就是选择权的这样一个问题。
If the script is already written,
如果剧本已经写定,
then we could say that everything in the perception of the world is predetermined.
那我们就可以说，在表象层面的所有的情况全都是已经注定的。
And if everything in this world is predetermined, then there really is no choice.
如果这个世界里面所有的一切细节都已经是事先注定的，那么实际上我们在这个层面上是没有选择权的。
This is a very strong teaching in destiny.
这个是实际上是一个非常强的一个教导，就是关于这个宿命论的一个教导。
Now philosophers for many years have talked about free will.
然后在世界各地的哲学家们在很多年都一直在探讨这个问题，就是你有没有自由选择权。
And in the Course in Miracles, in the clarification of terms.
然后在奇迹课程里对那个在奇迹课程的后面那个附注里面也说
，It says Jesus says God created Christ with free will.
他说上主创造了圣灵是通过他的自由选择权创造圣灵。
And that this free will is in heaven.
然后这个自由选择权只有在天国才有。
And this free will is for eternal happiness.
然后这个自由选择是选择永恒的喜悦。
But free will does not have anything to do with choice.
但是这个自由选择权跟我们所说的这个世间的选择是没有关系的。
That is the mistake that the philosophers make.
然后这些哲学家呢，实际上犯了很大的错误。
So, you deciding to study A Course in Miracles was part of the script.
所以你决定选择修行奇迹课程，实际上是剧本的一部分。
And Jesus says in the introduction to his book,
然后基督在期间课程的那个前言里面说,
free will does not mean you can establish the curriculum.
就是自由选择权并不意味着你可以决定这个课程的形式是什么样的。
It just means you can decide what you want to take at a given time.
它只是说你在不同的时间点上，你能够接纳的东西，你是可以选择的。
And then, in the manual for teachers at the back of the book,
然后在后面教师手册里面也说,
he says that even the form of the curriculum is already decided. It's not your choice.
他说就连是这个课程的所有的形式实际上也是事先已经决定好了，你没有选，在这方面没有选择。
So it was predetermined that you would study the Course in Miracles and your brother would study I Ching.
所以这个确实是已经事先注定好了，你会对奇迹课程感兴趣，修行这个，然后你的弟弟对易经感兴趣。
The only meaningful choice that remains for the mind that is sleeping.
在沉睡的心灵来讲，唯一有意义的选择就是
is the choice of purpose in mind that it will serve.
是这个目的性到底是什么？ 它对这个心灵的觉醒起一个什么样的目的？
So every moment the mind is deciding between the ego and the spirit.
所以在每一个时间点，你实际上只是在选择小我还是圣灵。
Between love and fear.
选择爱或者恨，或者是恐惧。
But this choice has nothing to do with the script of the world.
但是对于这个剧本上面所涉及的这些东西，你是没有选择权的。
So this is a very advanced state of mind.
所以这个实际上是一个已经很高深的一个心灵的层次。
To decide only for spirit or for forgiveness.
在这个状态下，你就会知道你只是选择圣灵。
Then you can simply let the whole script pass you by.
如果你每次都能知道你只是在选择圣灵的话，你就可以让剧本上的这一切就是该发生的就发生。And
that is the teachings of Jesus in the Gospel of Thomas.
所以这个不仅是基督的教诲，也是当时那个圣托马斯的教诲。He
says, be passers-by. Let the world go by.
他说你就让这个世界就是随身而过这样。
Don't put your attention into trying to figure out the world.
不要把你的精力放在试图解释或者是了解这个世界。
Dividing the world into good and bad and right and wrong.
或者把这个世界分成一些细枝末节，什么是好的，什么是坏的。
And don't think that you must find the form to choose your way out of this world.
甚至你不需要去定义各种各样不同的 这个现象，然后去决定自己怎么样才能觉醒过来。
The Holy Spirit will tell you everything that you need to know.
圣灵会告诉你你所需要知道的一切。
So the prayer in A Course in Miracles,
所以在奇迹课程中有这样的祈祷词,
is Holy Spirit decide for God.
他是说圣灵请为上主，请选择上主，请为我选择上主。
For me.
为我选择上主。
That is what prayer is all about.
所以这个就是真正祈祷的精髓到底是什么。
So to see this is a huge relief.
所以如果你能够意识到这一点的话，这将是对你一个彻底的释放。
It means you can pull your attention away from all the images.
就意味着你可以把你所有的注意力都从这个外界表象的一切都收回来。
And really begin to pray and feel what feels right in your heart.
然后只是着重于去感受到底你的心灵中什么是感觉是对的。
And this is a topic that has come up in my visits to China.
然后这个以前在我来中国的时候也曾经出现过这个话题。
Because when we say the word script, we have a linear picture.
因为每次当我们提到剧本的时候，我们都会考虑这个剧本是在线性时间上发生的。
And the Holy Spirit's purpose is to show us that everything is simultaneous. Everything is happening in the same moment. And we never had the power to arrange things in a linear line.
然后我们从来也没有这个能力去在线性的基础上去安排事情是应该怎么发生。
And this is why we can say, I do not know what anything is for.
所以在这种情况下你就可以说我不知道这些事情到底是为什么。
We are letting go of ordering time and space.
我们也不会再试图去安排时间和空间。
And praying to the Holy Spirit, show me this world in a different way.
然后我们可以真正向圣灵祈祷，请你给我展现一个不同的世界。
Because all grievances are coming from a linear view of the script.
因为所有的痛苦和纠结也都是从线性时间的角度的这个剧本中产生的。
And from judgments of who did something wrong and who was harmed.
而且也源自于这个攻击性的评判，就是说这个人做了什么错事，谁做了什么对的事。
Yeah. So I think you can have a good talk with your brother and say, but we are on the same page.
所以你可以跟你的弟弟好好聊聊，你可以跟他说，我们实际上是共有的这个观点，是一样的，是一致的。
谢谢。 我可不可以这样理解，就是我个人的理解是，剧本当中安排好的一切该怎么样发生怎么发生，但是我现在知道了有圣灵目光，所以说不管是好事坏事发生的时候，我现在尽可能的锻炼我在生活当中用圣灵目光来看待。
So can I summarize to understand this way? So everything that happens in the script, I just allow them to happen. And now I know that there is a perspective from the Holy Spirit, so I can train myself to always look at everything that happens in the script from the perspective of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Sure.
And even simpler, we talked yesterday about two words, give and get.
甚至更简单的是，昨天我们其实谈到这一点，就是说是给还是取。
So if we look at even coming to this weekend retreat as being part of the script.
所以我们可以看，其实大家来到这个周末的这个工作坊，实际上也是剧本的一部分。
And seeming to be here with a group of people.
然后看上去我们跟一群的道友一起。
Of course, that's all part of the script.
这些都是剧本的一部分。
But the purpose for this is really what is important.
但是这个剧本就是这个片段的目的，背后的目的到底是什么，才是最重要的问题。
Did I come to the session this morning to give?
那我今天早上来到这个会场是来给予的。
Or did I come to the session to get something?
还是我来到这儿去获取。
And that will determine whether we are with the Holy Spirit or the ego.
就在这一点上就能决定我们到底是跟圣灵在一起还是跟小我在一起。
So you pay close attention to your motive.
所以你要把重点放在你看到你背后的动机。
And are not concerned at all about the form.
不用考虑到表象到底发生什么事情。
And that helps you practice.
你可以这样去进行练习。
比如说在我们练习宽恕的过程当中，我们选择交通嘛，交通之后经常就会有一个疑问，就是那到底哪个是小我给我的声音，哪一个是圣灵给我的声音。我曾经是被这个问题困惑过，后来我是自己感悟的，不知道对不对，问一下老师，就是我选择圣灵之后，它会让我特别心安，然后呢，有可能会因为我的选择 给别人造成困扰，这是一定的，因为我的现在思维跟大部分世俗的思维是不一样的。我曾经纠结过，因为我的这种思维，我心安了，但是旁边的人可能不心安。但是我进一步选择宽恕，就是不管身边的人什么反应、什么状态，我依然选择交托。
Okay, so
this is another question that I want confirmation from you. I have been thinking a lot about how to know which voice is the Holy Spirit and which voice is the ego. And my personal experience is when I follow the Holy Spirit, I feel peaceful. So I know that's the Holy Spirit. But at the same time, I also know that even because my way of thinking is very different from other people around me, so my choice inevitably makes other people upset. So even after my surrendering and forgiveness, I feel peaceful. I know that other people will be affected and feel upset. So I guess my question is, in those situations, I just need to keep forgiving and keep surrendering and don't worry about how other people feel. Just keep moving forward with it.
Yes, that's exactly it. You just described the story of my life.
是的，你就你刚才所描述的就是我的生活状态。
好，大家好。我想先简单分享一下我后来的一点经历。今天早上在课开始之前，然后大家都在这里聊天。
First, I want to share some of my experiences this morning. So this morning, before we start the class, we were all here chatting. And I was standing at the corner watching everybody. And I feel very moved. And I feel like it's very precious for us to be on the same pathway together. And all of us have experienced a lot of pain. But suddenly I realized that nobody really practiced the course for themselves. We're all here for other people, even for the whole. So we're really here, we're trying very hard to find our way home. I know that there is a saying in the course, nobody can go home alone.
原来我理解是说少了任何一个兄弟，大家都没有办法回到家里去。
My previous understanding was that nobody can really wake up without other people.
可是当时我突然感觉到，没有任何一个人想把任何一个兄弟落下。
But this morning I suddenly had this realization that nobody really wants anyone to be left behind.
所以我是很感动。
That's why it really touched me.
我知道在现实生活中我们会甚至和自己的亲弟兄弟去竞争。
And I know in our lives sometimes we feel competitive even with our mighty companions.
我们去评判自己的兄弟，我也感到经常会有人评判我。
And we judge our brothers, and I also feel I'm always judged by our close friends too. But that very moment, I feel very peaceful. Because I see that all of that was just illusion. It's like a very thin veil covering the truth.
有一个声音跟我说，我们只愿兄弟喜悦。
And a voice inside me telling me that all we really want is our brothers to be happy.
我非常感谢你们所有。
That's why I'm so grateful for all of you.
然后我的问题就是，当我刚接触奇迹课的时候，我觉得。好像解答了我很多很深层次的疑惑。
And here comes my question. When I studied the course, I thought Of Course Miracles answered most of my concerns and worries.
但是我继续学习下去，会发现脑子有很多很多关于课程的问题。
But the more I study, the more questions that arises in my mind around the course.
后来又 不同的人会给我不同的建议。
And there are more suggestions and explanations that were given to me by other people.
有些人说，问出这些问题并且找到答案，可以增强你的热心，可以让你更信这个课程。
Some people tell me that, you know, identify those problems and find the answers to the problems can help you to better understand the course, can help you go faster.
另一种观点是说，这只是一种不断的制造问题，并且去问来解决问题，企图找到答案，只是小我一种拖延的抗拒手段。
And some other people would tell me that keep trying to find problems and trying to find solutions is just another ego trick to delay.
所以我现在不知道我这些问题是为了信而问，还是为了不信而问。
So I don't really know all these questions that I have in my mind. Am I asking it to try to believe the course or try not to believe the course?
这是我的。
That's my question.
Yes, I think as you deepen with the spirit, the questions will all dissolve away.
对，我想跟你说，就是说，当你跟着这个圣灵一步一步走得更深入的时候，你脑子中的问题全都会被解答。
In fact, I would say any question that is aimed at the world or figuring out the world is not a question at all.
我可以这样绝对的跟你说，就是说，任何对这个世界外在的表象世界的任何问题，实际上都不是真正的问题。
Because questions about the world are really just ego statements.
因为任何对这个方面的问题，实际上都是小我的一个表达而已。
So a helpful question could be aimed at your mind or your consciousness.
所以比较有帮助的问题是对你的心灵和对你的意识有跟这个有关的问题。
For example, what meaning am I giving to this situation?
比如说，我对这个情形，我对它赋予的意义到底是什么？
This is reflecting the second workbook lesson. I have given everything I see all the meaning that it has for me.
这也就是在那个练习手册第二课，就是说，所有的发生的一切都是我赋予它们所有的意义，跟这个相辅相成。
So when you ask a question that helps you get in touch with a false belief or a false idea, this is a very helpful question.
所以每当你的这个问题能够指引你更加深入的去发现内心里面的一些错误的概念或者错误的想法的时候，这些都是比较有帮助的一些问题。
And this will help to dissolve all the questions.
然后这样真正的有帮助的问题能够帮你把其他那些假问题全都扫清。
There was a very famous Eastern teacher called Ramana Maharshi.
然后当时在东方我们曾经有过一个非常著名的一个行者叫马哈希达，他是著名的。
And he founded his whole practice on one question, who am I?
然后他的整个的修行的道路就是围绕着一个问题，我是谁这一个问题。
He said all other questions are really not of concern.
他说其他的所有的其他的问题实际上都不需要你花精力去想。
So the ego asked the very first question.
所以小我实际上是问出的是这个世界的第一个问题。
Which is who am I?
这个问题就是我是谁。
Because Christ never asked this question.
因为圣灵永远不会问这个问题。
And then the ego made up many more questions to make it seem very complicated and difficult.
然后小我从这个问题衍生出来的其他所有的非常复杂的问题去试图解答。
I think of it in terms of quantum physics.
有时候我从量子物理学的这个角度去想。
When I look at all the people who are in this room right now, I see a beautiful reflection of my mind.
每当我现在看到这个屋子里面你们所有的人，我看到的是对我的心灵的一个反射，美好的反射。
Because you have all come from different parts of China.
因为你们是从中国不同的角落过来的。
And all with one purpose in mind.
然后每一个人的心里都有这样的一个目的。
To know thyself.
知道要了解自己的真我本性的这个目的。
And so this is like a forgiveness pageant to me.
所以这个就像是一个宽恕的大会一样，对我来讲。
For example, in a beauty pageant, people would come from all parts of China to demonstrate their beauty.
So, 比如说像一个选美大会的话，那我们就是从中国会从各个不同的城市会选来所有的人去竞争他们的外表。
But since this is a forgiveness pageant, all of you have come from all over China to demonstrate forgiveness.
但是因为这个是一个宽恕的大会，所以你们从中国的各个地方来了，只是去为了显示你们自己内心宽恕的这个愿心。
So I feel the same way you feel. I feel such honor.
所以我跟你当时的那个感受是一样的。我觉得非常荣幸。
That we have all been brought together by the Spirit for one purpose.
非常荣幸，就是我们都被圣灵指引着到了这个地方，都是为了同一个目的。
And in that sense, we are all family.
在这个从这种角度来讲，我们大家都是一个家庭的成员。
And I mean that in the deepest way.
我是从心里面这样说的。
We have all become lifelong companions in this journey.
我们在这条路上实际上是一生的导游。
And I think it's good to think about it in that way.
我觉得我们实际上这样能够这么想是很好的。
Every week I have people who write emails to me or send me messages.
因为每天我都会收到全世界其他的朋友给我写信。
And sometimes they will tell me their story. It could be very extreme.
他们有时候会给我们会跟我讲他们的人生经历，有时候是非常极端的一些经历。
But oftentimes they say, but I'm really writing you to join with you.
但他们通常到写到最后的时候就会说，我实际上给你写这封信的目的就是想跟你有一个链接。
And every reply that I send to the message is always, yes, let's join together.
然后我给他们的回信实际上也都是这样回复，就是好的，让我们链接在一起。
Whether we join in a communication or a project,
不管是我们是通过语言上的交流来链接，还是通过共同的从事一项项目。
Or whether I invite them to come to one of our centers,
或者是我邀请他们到我们的中心来。
It's always a feeling of joining.
都是一个在内心里面的一个链接的感觉。
Just this past week, I was communicating with a woman who had a very extreme life.
就在上一个星期，我跟一个朋友在链接，她的一生是非常的坎坷。
She was bought and sold as part of a sex trade ring.
她当时是曾经就是被买卖，就是像那个性交易，或者是就是这种交易中，她是这个被买来卖去的这样。
She had tried to kill herself when she was commit suicide when she was a teenager.
她十几岁的时候曾经尝试过自杀。
Her father was is still is addicted to drugs.
她的父亲是吸毒的。
She has no money.
她也没有钱。
She's just on the move, living with friends.
她就是每天就是去跟朋友在朋友家里住一下。
But the more we prayed, it was apparent that she should come and visit our center in Mexico.
就是当我们在一起就是祈祷以后，就发现这个是一个非常明确的指引，她应该到我们墨西哥的那个中心来看，来住一下。
And so yesterday I saw that she put a funding request on the internet to help pay for her plane ticket.
所以昨天我就在网上看到他在网上发出了这样的一个，就是说集资，他能够以至于他能够买飞机票到我们墨西哥的那个中心去。
And so I shared it on some of the pages, and she reached her goal. She got enough money for a plane ticket.
所以我把他这个集资的这个要求也转发到其他不同的网站上，然后他最终也达到了这个目标。
And I think this is how the Spirit works. The Spirit always gives us whatever we need that will help us.
所以这就是圣灵是究竟是如何在我们生命中工作，他就是要给我们我们所需要的一切的东西。
Yeah. And so I feel that feeling of honor to be part of that plan.
然后我觉得非常荣幸，然后我能够是他所从事的这个大的计划中的一部分。
So we are all lifelong friends.
所以对于我来讲，我们都是一生的朋友。
Thank you for being that for me.
谢谢你们是我的朋友。
我刚才有一点莫名的心跳加速。
My heart is beating.
课程告诉我，我不是一具身体。练习手册告诉我说，我绝不是为了我认定的理由而烦恼，我只受上主天律的管辖。
So the course teaches me that I'm not a body, and the workbook lesson also says that 第一个课程是说什么？
第二个是我绝不是为了我认定的理由而烦恼。
I'm not upset for the reason I think, and I'm under no laws but God's.
课程还说，我只受上主天律的管辖。
I'm under no laws but God's.
在正文词汇解析的序言部分，有一句话这样说：说，不要再为神学理论所误导，我们本课程重视的是体验。
And also, it says don't.Focus on theology, but focus on experience.
我还听到一句话这样说：我们的存在荣耀了上主。
And also heard saying that our existence glorifies God.
我想请老师分享一下，你意识不到自己身体的这些喜悦的经验，随便讲讲。
Can you give me some examples of your experience that the joy and the happiness when you realize you are not a body, when you don't feel your body?
Well, those lessons that you are mentioning have all been very, very, very dear to me.
你刚才所提到的这些练习手册对我来讲是非常非常宝贵的一些练习。
And I felt I asked Jesus,Please, you need to show me that these are true for me.
因为我当时曾经跟上主就说，你一定要展示给我，你所教我的这些都是真的。
And I realized that I had learned things that was blocking those lessons from awareness.
然后我也知道我在世间所学的这些知识实际上是已经阻断了我对这些课程这些你刚才所提到的一些课程的理解。
So those, we'll say those four main ideas was an opportunity for me to dive into an experience of that.
所以这个练习手册里面有四个最主要的观点是一直是帮助我加深我对奇迹课程的这个培训。
And the way that it happened for me was in 1991, Jesus told me, we're going traveling.
然后在1991年的时候，当时圣灵跟我说，我们现在要一起旅行了。
And he said, I will take care of everything.
然后他跟我说，我会帮助你照料好一切的事情。
I will tell you where to go. I will take care of food, sleeping arrangements, transportation.
然后他会我会告诉你要去哪里，我会帮你解决住宿问题、吃饭问题，还有一切其他的问题。
And so for 5 years, he took me on a road trip.
所以在后来的五年里面，我一直在路上旅行。
Where I didn't know where I was going to be going, or where I would sleep, or where I would get food.
然后在这五年的时间，我每天都不知道我到底是去哪，我有没有住宿，我有没有饭吃。
I had to learn to experience. I am under no laws but God's.
我是必须要给自己这样的一个切身的体验，就是我是不受其他的那个法，我只是在上主的那个。
And so I shared many of my experiences about that when I came here to China. Of traveling around like an Indian sannyasi, of trusting every day everything would be provided.
就是我当时在旅行的时候就好像是印度的那些行者一样他们也不知道在每天在哪里落脚或者每天要吃什么。
Yeah. And Susie and my friend over here were practicing this in China.
然后我也知道我有一些朋友像张彤啊像其他的一些朋友他们也是当时我讲完了以后他们也把这个付于实践。
Yes, we would see them and hear about them hopping on a train and going to Beijing and everything being provided. When the Course says that our existence should be to glorify God,
然后当奇迹课程里面说我们的存在是荣耀上主的时候,
it means our attitude, our state of mind should glorify the Creator.
他说的是实际上是我们的这个一个心灵状态实际上是应该是荣耀上主的。
So whenever we are happy, God is glorified.
所以每当我们是处于喜悦的这个心灵状态的时候那么上主就被荣耀了。
When it says, I am under no laws but God's, it means that the Spirit will provide everything that we need. So when I traveled around for 5 years with Jesus, I didn't know where I was going to sleep. Some days I would watch the sun going down and I had no idea where I would lay my body. But I went to many Course in Miracles groups in the United States and Canada. And sometimes during the Course in Miracles group, somebody, a student would say, where are you from? I said, oh, I'm just traveling around. I don't have a home. And they would say, where will you sleep tonight? I said, I don't know. And sometimes I would get 2 or 3 invitations from the Course group. To go home and sleep at their house. And then I would say, I have to pray. I have to learn how to pray because I need to know which one I'm supposed to go with.
So I found that the actual situation is that I usually need to pray to decide which one to choose.
They would offer me food or sleep on a bed or a couch. I had a very small car and sometimes they would offer to put gasoline in the car. And so every day I got to practice I am under no laws but God. Because I had no bank account, no savings, no career, no organization or church supporting me. I had to trust every day that whatever I needed would be there. But But because of all my past conditioning, it took me about 5 years to really get the lessons.
但因为我有很多的这种局限性的理念，所以对我来讲，要花5年的时间才能完全的接受这个。
And every day I practice the lesson. I am never upset for the reason I think.
然后每一天我也是一直在练习这个功课，就是我不是我自己认为的原因而烦恼。
If I was hungry, I'd say, I'm not upset for the reason I think.
然后如果我饿了的话，我也会对自己说，我不是因为我自己认为的原因而烦恼。
If I was too hot or too cold.
如果我是感觉到很热或者很冷。
Say the lesson in my mind.
我也会记忆重复这一刻，在我的脑海中记忆重复这一刻。
And then the next lesson, I'm upset because I see something that's not there.
然后有下一刻，就是说我烦恼的原因是因为我看到了不存在的东西。
I see only the past.
我只看到的是过去的想法。
And my mind is preoccupied with past thoughts.
然后我的心灵中充满了过去的想法。
So I knew that it was always about my thinking.
So 我知道这一切都是只是跟我的想法和心理有关。
But there were so many miracles of people offering me things, so many things.
但是这在一程上有那么多的奇迹，有这么多的人要求给我不同的东西。
That these miracles showed me that Jesus was watching over me.
So 这些奇迹让我切身的体验到基督是一直在保护着我。
And there was so much happiness and so much joy.
然后这个在这个过程中实际上我体验到了无比的喜悦。
I felt like I stepped into a fairy tale.
我感觉到我好像在活在童话当中。
A very happy fairy tale.
是一个非常喜悦的童话。
And it just continued on for 5 years.
然后它一直持续地进行了五年之间。
Until Jesus guided me to a house.
然后一直到基督指引我去买了一个房子。
And I said, "What am I now? Am I supposed to have a house after all these years of travel?"
然后我跟他说，怎么这么多年的旅行完了以后，你竟然让我固定下来买一个房子吗？
He said yes.
他说是。
This was preparing me for world travels.
然后当时这一举动实际上是给我准备让我去全世界开始旅行。
So a house was donated.
So 当时就是有一个人捐赠给我们一个房子。
Where I could pray and rest.
然后我可以在那个房子里面去祈祷，也可以休息。
When I would come back from traveling to many countries.
然后我每一次在全世界旅行了以后，就有一个固定的地点可以跟我休息。
And not only a house, but Jesus gave me 2 cats.
然后不仅仅他给了我一个房子，还给了我2只猫。
These were my companions.
然后当时这个就是我的陪伴。
One had 3 legs.
有一个有3条腿。
Tripod.
3脚架。
And one had 4 legs.
有另外一只是有4条腿。
Her sister Angel.
Tripod sister.
Yeah, Angel.
然后是3脚架的姐姐叫天使。
Yeah. And over the years, this little cat tripod was the most common face in my life.
在这么多年里面，实际上三脚架的那张脸是我生命中最长久持续在我生命中的一张脸。
When I traveled, the faces were always changing.
因为我在全世界旅行的时候，我身边的那些面孔总是不断的变化的。
But always, tripod was waiting back at the house.
但是不管怎么样，三脚架那张脸总是在家里等着我。
So people say, "Did you have a relationship with this cat?" Yes, I did.
所以他们问你跟这只猫有一个亲密关系吗？我就会说是的。
That was my partner.
这个就是我的伴侣。
And so it continues on, where I just trust that I'm under no laws but God's.
所以从那个时候就是一直就是开启了我一直信任我是只是受上主天律管辖的这样的一个体验。
But I had to be convinced.
但是我是必须要允许自己是被说服，被圣灵来说服。
Thank you.
We have someone back over there.
My ego can't wait anymore. I need to have 不错。
Okay.
啊，他们昨天晚上一直说要问八卦，也不问，现在不问一下。
they
said they want to talk about gossip last night.
Gossip?
八卦。我问一下，老师，你帮我看看，我这啥时候能找到我的灵魂伴侣呀？
I want to see whether you can predict when I can find my soulmate. And what do I have to do in order to find my soulmate?
Very good. I get this question every once in a while.
我这时不时的就会碰到这个问题。
I remember I was in Ireland and I got asked the same question.
我记得我当时在爱尔兰的时候，曾经有人问过我同样的一个问题。
And then before I could answer, the woman said, I think I'm supposed to offer my house to you for a retreat.
然后当时他问的这个问题，在我还没来得及回答的时候，他就说，另外我觉得我应该把我的那个房子捐赠给你，让你去用那个房子去做一个工作房。
And she had three houses.
然后实际上她是有三个房子。
On an island off the coast of Spain.
然后她是在西班牙的一个小岛上，有三个房子。
And so I went there with Francis and a group for 6 weeks to her houses.
所以我当时就是跟 Francis 还有我们一个团队一起到那边去做了一个六星期的课程。
And she told me before that we got there.
然后他就跟我们说，在我们到那个他的房子去做那个课程之前。
She was fixing up the houses for the retreat.
然后他当时把那个要的房子进行装修，去准备给我们开课。
And a man came to help her do this.
然后他当时雇了一个人去帮他做装修。
And she said he was the soulmate.
然后他说那个是他的灵魂伴侣。所以。
So she didn't ever ask me to directly tell her what to do.
所以她当时在跟大卫那个问这个问题的时候，她并没有问他，就是你要告诉我，我具体该怎么做。
She first offered the gift.
她问了这个问题以后，马上就是给出了一个礼物。
She said that Jesus and the Holy Spirit had been telling her, she'd been asking them for 5 years and offering her houses to them.
她说她在心里面跟圣灵和基督祈祷的时候，就是把她那个房子交给圣灵，交托给基督已经5年了。
And so she said, why are Jesus and the Holy Spirit not taking me up on my offer?
她说为什么圣灵和基督不接受我的礼物呢？
But when she offered the houses to be used for retreat, then the soulmate was given as well.
但是当他问这个问题以后，紧接着把这个他的房子交付出来，说给我们做工作坊以后，紧接着他的灵魂伴侣也出现了。
So this is how it works with soulmates.
所以这就是这个到底这个灵魂伴侣会怎么一回事？
Yes, you offer a gift. You offer a gift to Jesus and the Holy Spirit.
所以你需要向圣灵和基督交托给圣灵和基督你的礼物。
And you give it with all of your heart.
你把你的心，然后和这个礼物全都交给圣灵和基督。
And then everything that would be helpful for you in the forgiveness process.
然后一切对你进行宽恕和心灵解脱有好处的这些情形，
it comes to you.
都会被圣灵和基督安排在。
It comes into your dream as a dream symbol.
它会甚至会来到你的梦境中。
And Jesus is the best matchmaker.
然后其实基督是最好的红娘。
It really works when you offer the gift of your willingness to forgive.
真的是这样运作的。如果当你把你的愿心，需要宽恕的这个愿心交给基督的话。
In this case, this woman Amara already knew what she was offering.
在刚才我们这个例子里边，当时这个人他知道他已经心里很清楚他想要交付的这个礼物是什么。
And then she realized, oh, I'm supposed to offer my houses to you, David, to use for the Holy Spirit's purpose.
她当时就是一下找到这个灵感，就说我要把我的房子让你去做这个课程，以示就是说交给你和圣灵去造福于大家。
And then when she was so busy fulfilling her gift,
然后她在过去，然后在身后的几个月，她就非常的忙碌去准备装修这个房子。
She forgot about her question about the soulmate.
她实际上等于把这个脑子里面这个烦恼已经忘记了，忘记她非常想要找的一个灵魂伴侣，对不对？
And yet, this man showed up in her house to help her do her.Help her with her gift.
然后然而这个人来到他的生命中去帮他一起准备这份礼物。
And by the time I arrived, to the house,
然后当我们后来最终到他们那个房子里面去做这个课程的时候，
she told me the whole story, how she had found her soulmate.
他可以跟我们讲这个整个这个故事，到底他是怎么找到他的灵魂伴侣的。
So it's not like we should pursue something in form directly.
所以并不是说我们要去在这个外界去寻找我们所想要的东西。
If we devote ourselves to following the Spirit, then whatever will be helpful will come to us very easily.
如果我们就是有这个决心，就是只是跟随上主的指引走的话，那么对我们有帮助的一切的人和事情都会来到我们生命中。
I look at this in my life. When I look around this room, I see an amazing group of people.
然后我就在我的生命中也是这样。但我现在放眼看到整个这个屋子的人，我觉得你们是一群非常不可思议的一个群体。
And when I think about our community around the world, they are also just amazing people.
如果我想我们在全球的这些，在我们中心里面的这些灵性社区里面的成员的话，我也认为他们是一群非常不可思议的一个群体。
Yeah, they are so devoted.
因为他们非常的有奉献精神。
If you met them, you would say, "Oh my, these are very devoted people."
如果你遇到他们的话，你一定会。感受到他们是多么的就把一生都奉献给这个目的。
Even the animals in our community are amazing.
哪怕是我们社区里面这些小动物都是非常不可思议的。
Amazing cats and dogs and horse.
我们有猫，有狗，有马。
We have amazing animals as well as amazing people.
非常不同寻常的动物，也非常不同寻常的人。
But they all come from a devoted purpose.
但他们都来自于这一个共同的目的，就是要把身心奉献给这一个觉醒。
Yeah. So that's the way to go about it.
所以这个是我们去解决任何问题的这个方法。
It's back to that thing of giving. What do I have to give?
最终还是回到这个给予的问题，就是我到底能够给予什么？
Or what do I have to offer or to contribute?
我能够交付出什么东西来。
And Jesus will say, thank you, and give it back tenfold.
然后当你交给圣灵和基督以后，他就会说谢谢你，然后他会以十倍的情况返还给你。
谢谢老师，我有个问题。昨天晚上我就想问一个问题，今天呢，正好这个老师说的这个就是灵性社区的这个事情，正好这个想，我想把这个问题提一下。
I have a question about the spiritual community.
因为这个问题其实也困扰了我好多年了。我在2010年的时候就想筹建一个这个灵性社区这样一个。
Because it has been on my mind for many years. I've been wanting to set up a spiritual community for a long time.
我的条件来说，就是每天啊，感觉到其实处在这种。只有这种点是日用灵粮的那种水平，他没有这种能力去做，只是说这是心愿，这是一个想法。
But the best it is just a wish, a beautiful wish. I don't really seem to have the ability to set it up.
但在这个过程中，在我们住在我居住的10公里外的一个地方呢，我找到了这片地方。
But about 10 kilometers outside of my house, I actually find the ideal location.
像仙境一样的一个环境。
It's very beautiful. It's like out of this world.
哎，现在这方正回来，你把这方打造成了一个旅游的圣地，和这个修养这个圣地。
And recently, the local government actually transformed that location into a resort for rejuvenation and for tourism.
就是说我原来那个想法呢，其实现在已经展现了。
So the original idea in my mind already takes shape now.
现在我在想问的问题就是说，这是舍我的这个欲望，还是这个圣灵在引领？
So I guess my question is, this desire, is that, does that come from the ego, or is that the guidance of the Holy Spirit?
因为就我现在这个条件来说，其实是不由我去想的。
Because it is too out of the question for me to do such an endeavor. I don't have any means to do that right now.
好，谢谢。
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, I have had many experiences like you are describing.
我就是也有很多这样的切身经历，就像你刚才所描述的这种感觉。
Where I would be given a very inspiring idea.
然后我是会收到一种非常受启发的一些灵性的指引。
But I would think, I have no idea how to make that happen.
但是我感觉到我是没有这个能力，我也不知道该怎么去执行。
And what Jesus always reminded me.
然后当时基督就一直在提醒我。
Is that he said, when I give you something to do,
他说当我让你去做一些事情的时候，
I will do it through you,
我会通过你去做这件事情，
and I will always give you the means,
我会给你去要达到这个目的的一切的东西。
And this seemed to contradict everything that I believed in.
然后这个跟我的固有的信仰是完全相反的。
Because when a human being decides to do something,
因为当一个人个体决定要去做一件事情的时候，
the goal comes first.
这个目标首先是达成了，形成了。
And then the means come second.
然后手段通常是随后发现的。
And Jesus said, "No, that's not how I work."
然后基督就说，这个不是我做事的方法。
When I give you a goal or an idea, I will give you the means.
如果我给你一个具体的目标，我也会给你行事的手段。
And an example is 1991 when he said we will be traveling.
就好像是当91年的时候，他跟我说我们需要开始旅行的时候。
I said how?
我当时就说怎么旅行啊？
I can't even imagine how I can travel.
我根本就想象不出来我能够怎么旅行。
And I had a small amount of money.
我当时有一点点的现金。
And he said, okay, first we'll go to a car dealership and buy a car.
然后他当时就说，把你这个现金全都去买一辆二手车。
So I spent about all my money on this very small car.
所以我把我基本上全部的这个现金全都换成了这个二手车，很小的一辆车。
But I still was not convinced. I said, "That's so. Now we have a car."
但我还是没有被说服。我当时就说，好，我现在有的只不过是一辆车而已。
But I had no money for gasoline.
我也没有钱去给车加油。
No money for food.
也没有钱去买吃的东西。
No money for lodging or hotels, motels.
也没有钱去住酒店或旅馆。
He said, "I'll take care of all that."
然后他说，我会帮你安排这其他这一切。
And so he told me where to drive.
所以他只不过是告诉我要去哪，往哪去开这个车。
And I kept driving. The trip lasted 5.5 weeks.
所以当时我就根据他的指示一直不停地开，然后当时这个持续了5.5个星期。
And I wasn't an established teacher of A Course in Miracles.
那个时候我甚至不是一个被认可的一个奇迹教师。
I was just studying the book.
我只不过只是一个小小的学员而已。
But as I traveled, people would offer me gasoline or a place to stay, food, everything was offered.
但是当我就是一直不停地按照他的指示去开车去到达不同的目的地的时候，人们就不同地向我提供住宿、饮食和这个汽车的 油汽油。
And so I was beginning to learn that when Jesus gives me a guidance, he also gives me the means to fulfill.
所以当时我就通过这个体验，我就学习到，只要是基督让我做的事情，他一定会给我提供执行的手段。
And this has happened to me so many times over these last 25 years.
在过去的25年中，这个在我身上发生了太多了。
It's just been one miracle after the next, after the next.
就是一个奇迹接着一个奇迹，接着另一个奇迹。
It's almost like a fairy tale that you can't even believe.
那这个简直就像一个童话一样，别人都相信不了。
And I would tell him, this is not the way things work on Earth.
然后我会跟他说，这个不是我们地球人生活的方式。
Like some kind of magic fairy tale.
就是我们没有人是生活在童话里。
And he said, this is how I work.
然后他说，这个是我工作的方式。
And this is very convincing.
而这个是非常有说服力的。
When we were growing up, you know, all of us wanted to be happy.
因为在我们从小到大，我们实际上都有这个要一定要快乐的这样的愿望。
And we had ideas about what we needed to do to be happy.
然后我们也有很多不同的想法，就是我们到底要做什么，成为什么才能快乐。
But Jesus said, "No, your ideas are not that important."
然后当时基督就跟我说，你的想法没有重要的想法。
I will give you the ideas, and I will give you the means to fulfill them.
我会给你想法，同时我会给你执行的方式，让你去达到这个想法。
And all you have to do is listen to me and follow.
你所要做的一切就是听从我，并且跟随我。
You need to do nothing else.
你没有任何其他需要做的。
Very simple, just listen and follow.
非常非常简单，就是听从和跟随。
I give you the instructions, you follow.
我会给你具体的指示，你就跟随他的指示。
And I was always asking questions.
然后我就是一直评论问题。
Always about the future.
总是问一些跟未来有关的问题。
And he said, please don't do that anymore.
他说，请你不要再继续问跟未来有关的问题了。
We're just taking this day by day and moment by moment.
我们只不过是就今天过今天的日子，这个时刻就过这个时刻的日子。
Because if you already think you know the future, you won't ask me. He said, you won't ask me what to do.
因为如果一旦你知道未来将会是发生什么事情的话，你就不会再转向我去问我究竟该怎么办了。
So we have had a friend.In Shanghai, that was interested in spiritual community. And we communicated some with him, but I don't think he was very committed to the idea. But if you feel strongly about the idea,
但如果你对这个想法感觉到是非常的强烈的一个愿望的话
，and it seems very important to you，
而且对你非常重要的话
，then the signs and the symbols will show you。
那么就会在你生命中就会出现不同的指示、指引和符号。
Because it's always a collaboration。
因为最终来讲，我们完成什么事情都是需要跟别人合作的。
Jesus never asked us to do anything alone。
基督不会让我们一个人完成一个很大的一个项目。
He's moving all the people around and all the images around.
他会把人从各个地方调到各个地方，然后把所有的影像调来调去。
And he said to me, "If you will be a miracle worker for me,"
他说，如果你是我的奇迹行者的话
，I will arrange time and space for you.
我会帮你安排时间和空间的一切事情。
And so I said, I don't know how that works.
然后我说我不知道你怎么达到这一点。
But you show me.
但是你向我展示一下吧。
And he keeps showing me this for 25 years, over and over. He shows me.
他在过去25年来就一直不停地向我展示这一点。
And I just am so grateful and so happy.
然后我就对他非常非常的感激，而且非常非常喜悦。Yeah.
I was speaking at a conference in Colorado.
我今年在科罗拉多的一个奇迹大会上发言。
And somebody in the audience said, David, who is your teacher?
然后当时在底下就有一个学员就发问，就说大卫，谁是你的老师？
I didn't hesitate. I said Jesus.
然后我一点都没有犹豫，就说基督是我的老师。
He just leads me in every day, everything in my life.
他每天都在不停地指引我，指引我做每一件事情。
Yeah.So if this is an important idea, the way will open.
所以如果这个是对你来讲非常重要的一个想法，一个事情的话，你要相信它这个指引会来到你身边。
Yeah, and it will be made clear.
然后而且会彰显得非常的明确，到底是什么样的指引。
谢谢。
Thank you. Thank you.
老师，我感觉自己被圣灵指引到这里。
I do feel like I come here, because I was guided to come.
当我第一次看见就是这个课程关于这个工作坊的信息的时候，就是阅读这个文字和视频嘛，就是。
When I first read about the information about this weekend, I watched some clips. I just feel very strongly in my heart that I'm supposed to come.
那我之前其实我这个今年才开始学习奇迹。
I started the course this year.
之前很多年是在新时代的这个灵性修行里面。
那 I've been following the New Age movement in the past few years.
当我看到那个工作坊信息的时候，我同时也升起一个愿望，想要有一天能够到那个平安社区。
Just as I was reading about the information about this weekend, I also had a desire arising that I want to visit your community.
然后今天你讲到就是关于这个灵性社区的一些信息。
And as you were talking about the information of your spiritual community.
其实我昨天听就是说没有想要关于这方面提问，但是心里面其实也还会有冒出一些念头，但是小我阻止了。然后今天这个话筒正好传到我这里，我就突然想问，就是我如果想要有一天去访问这个社区的话，我可以做点什么。
So I wanted to ask the questions yesterday, but the ego keeps stopping me. So today, as the microphone is here, I just want to take the opportunity to ask if I can go to your visit your spiritual community. What can I offer? What can I do?
Yeah, it's interesting when.We decided and felt guided to come to China.
这个真的是很有缘，因为就是我们受这个指引要停到中国来。
We had some friends that told us we are coming to the United States.
然后今年的话，也是我们其实有一些中国朋友当时给我打电话说我们要去你们美国，可不可以访问一下你们的社区？
And they said that we want to come to your community.
他们说我们想要去你的社区参观一下。
And Francis said we are coming to China.
然后我问了他时间以后，我说那个时间我们在中国呀。
Didn't you know we are coming to China?
难道你没有收到信息我们来中国吗？
And they said no. So
没有收到。
So they did go to the United States.
所以他们确实是当时已经计划他们去了美国。
And we came to China.
然后我们来了中国。
But they said, we want to host you at a friend's hotel in Shanghai.
然后他说，你们这次来，我们本来想是在上海接待你们，因为我们有一个灵性酒店。
The next time that you come to China.
那不如就下次吧，下次你再过来。
Yeah. So.Francis was just saying yesterday that she would like to be in the community when people come over from China.
然后昨天我Francis 就跟我说，如果要是有中国的朋友来我们的社区的话，他们希望能够在场的，能够帮助介绍一些情况。
So she could help translate for them and be helpful.
因为他也可以这样帮助大家翻译，也可以真正做到有帮助。
But Yeah, we just pray about everything, including people who want to visit. And oftentimes we have them fill out an application form.
然后通常的我们的步骤的话，就是先让这些有愿心的朋友先填了一个申请表。
Because we, it's helpful to know the skills that could be used in the projects.
因为这个申请表能够帮我们了解这些朋友到底本身有一些什么技能，然后他们来了以后可以一起共同从事什么项目。
For example, Colin has visited our community in Mexico.
比如说像嘉豪，他来过我们墨西哥的那个中心来访问过。
And now, while he's back in China, he helps maintain our Chinese website.
所以现在他哪怕回到中国，他还是在帮我们去维护我们在中国的这个网站。
So those are skills with language and webmaster skills.
所以他的这个就是在技术方面的这个技能，还有他语言上的这个技能，就是很有帮助。
When Colin first asked about coming to our community,
当他第一次向我们询问来我们社区的这个愿望的时候，
he wrote many emails to Francis and to me.
他给我们两个人写了很多的信。
And finally, Francis said, "You need to learn English."
然后最后 Francis 就跟他说，你一定要学英语。
So Colin learned a whole new language. English.
他就把英语学得非常好。
Which helps him in translations and things that we work with now.
嗯，所以到一直到现在的话，他的这个技能也能够帮非常有帮助，对翻译啊，或者是网站非常有帮助。
Yes. So it all starts with a request or a prayer.
所以一开始通常都是由一个祈祷或者一个愿心引起的。
Where you have an idea or an intention.
你有一个想法，或者是有一个决心要做什么事情。
And usually that's followed by communications.
然后通常接下来的话就是有一些交流。
Where we take it to prayer.
然后这样使得我们可以把这个进行祈祷。
And feel the inspiration.
然后我们感知到就是指引到底是一个什么方向。
And the prayer is always, how can this help the whole?
然后我们的祈祷通常都是在问圣灵，这件事情能不能造福于全体。
For example, years ago, a friend of ours, Albert, translated my book into Mandarin.
比如说几年以前，涂永江曾经帮助我们把大卫的很多材料都翻译成中文。
But when we asked about publishing the book.
但是我们当时当问到要出版我们的材料的时候，
it never really became obvious to publish the book here in China.
我们没有收到一个非常明确的指示或指引，说是要在中国正式的出版我们的书籍。
So we published the book in America.
所以我们在美国发行了我们的这个书籍。
And we make it available through a paperback and an ebook.
然后我们既有这个纸，这个真正的这个书的版本，也有那个电子书的版本。
But we've just prayed about this all these years.
但是这几年来，我们一直也是在为这个问题祈祷。
And whatever comes very easily.
然后不管最后的结果是什么，都是一个最简单的一个结果。
The Spirit never pushes anything.
然后圣灵永远不会是去强求某件事情。
Yeah, so it's good to know about your requests.
所以我们很高兴能够知道你的这个愿心。
And there may be a group that comes over from Shanghai.
可能会在上海有一些朋友，可能有一群人都非常想来我们的社区参观。
And it will probably be organized at a time when Francis is there to receive them.
我们可以就是说看看怎么安排，选一个时间是 Francis 能够在社区的时候，然后接待大家。
Yeah. And also, it may be that the community does arise here in China.
另外也是有这个可能，就是说一个灵性社区有可能会真的在中国成立。
For some time, Francis has been feeling a very strong draw to Asia.
然后在最近的一段时间 ，Francis 感觉到非常强烈的，就是要回到亚洲的这样一个愿心。
Even though she was born in Beijing and has lived in Australia and the United States,
她是出生于北京，但是也生活在澳大利亚，然后现在生活在美国。
It's just been recently that she's felt a very strong call back to Asia.
但在最近的一段时间里，她感觉到了非常强的这个召唤，就是在亚洲的同胞们对这个的召唤。
And specifically China and Japan.
然后具体的就是主要是中国和日本。
And so we take notice of that.
所以我们对此也是非常重视的。
And I think that's part of the reason why we are here now.
所以这也就是为什么我们这次要来的原因之一。
Yeah, we just prayed about it and we felt it.
然后我们就是祈祷了以后，我们确实感受到这个召唤。
And also, when we leave here, there's a big group of excited people in Tokyo waiting for us.
然后我们离开这里以后，我们有一大群非常兴奋的朋友在日本等着我们。
And Francis has been joining with the Japanese translator of A Course in Miracles.
因为 Francis 一直在跟那个日本的，就是奇迹课程的翻译者一直在有交流。
She would like to come from New York City and do an event with us in Japan.
Cool.
Is Yusuko?
然后当时这个翻译的这个人，他当时也是希望从纽约，因为他住在纽约之后，他愿意从纽约飞到日本来，跟我们一起在日本做一些课程。
So things are in motion for coming back.
所以有很多的安排其实是在进行当中的，就是会召唤我们回到亚洲来。
It's time.
Okay.
So we've reached lunchtime.
所以现在差不多是午间休息时间。
So everybody enjoy your lunch and we'll come back at 2:30.
希望大家能够享受你们的午餐，然后我们两点半回来。
Just like yesterday.
像昨天一样，谢谢。
Thank you.